everyone. I'm so glad that you're here to learn about God's Word and Jesus' work. I'm so excited that you can do it at home with your family. Let's start with some music.
Every move I make, I make in you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Woo! Every step I take, I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be? 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 Na 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 na. Every move I make, I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Woo-hoo! Every step I take, I take in you. On my way, Jesus, every breath I take, I breathe in you. Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be? 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 How can it be?
Our story today is about a mountaintop experience. Usually when people say that, they're talking about an amazing time in their life. What is a mountaintop experience that you have had? Maybe it was a spiritual experience, or maybe it was just something that has been a highlight in your life. Pause the video here to talk with your family about your mountaintop experiences. Let's start by hearing today's story. Get your Bibles and follow along with me as I read Luke chapter 9, verses 28 through 36. This story is also on page 358 of the Spark Story Bible. Now, about 8 days after these sayings, Jesus took with him Peter and John and James and went up on the mountain to pray. And while he was praying, the appearance of his face changed, and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly they saw two men, Moses and Elijah, talking to him. They appeared in glory and were speaking of his departure, which he was about to accomplish at Jerusalem. Now Peter and his companions were weighed down with sleep, but since they had stayed awake, they saw his glory and the two men who stood with him. Just as they were leaving, Peter said to Jesus, "Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." Not knowing what he said. While he was saying this, a cloud came and overshadowed them, and they were terrified as they entered the cloud. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, "This is my Son, my chosen. Listen to him." When the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone, and they kept silent, and in these days they told no one of any of the things that they had seen. The disciples were used to seeing Jesus in one way, but they were beginning to get small glimpses of what Jesus was really like. The experience on the mountain showed them what his true glory looked like. It made the connection between Jesus and the Old Testament prophets. And for the second time, God spoke from a cloud and identified Jesus as God's Son. Jesus was the same, but different. He appeared in a different form. He was both human and God. Now I want you to pause the video here and find the activity sheets that you started way back in January. Our season of Epiphany has come to an end with a final story about Jesus being revealed as God's Son. Let's review the stories that we have heard in this unit. We have Jesus reading from a scroll in the synagogue in Nazareth, Jesus with a crowd of angry people, Jesus calling the first disciples and the large catch of fish, the blessings and the woes, and love your enemies. Now let's discover today's story. Today we hear about a mystical mountaintop experience. Open the final door to reveal today's story. What do you see? What do you think this means for our story today? Pause the video here to talk to your family about what this means and color the picture as you do. Today, we are hearing a story about Jesus changing, so let's practice spotting some change. Choose one person in your family to go first. While the rest of you close your eyes, the one person you choose should change one small thing about their appearance. The only rule is that you need to change something that is visible. When you're ready, tell everyone to open their eyes and guess what you've changed. The first person to guess correctly will be the next person to change something. Pause the video here to play the game. This next game requires some setup. You will need the glow sticks and the balloons from your Anyday Sunday School bag. And once you get them, break the glow sticks and put them into the balloons before you blow them up. Then blow them up and tie up the balloon. Pause the video here to get ready. Jesus calls us to spread his word to everyone, so we can share the glow of Jesus using your balloons. Turn off a few lights in the room, but make sure that you can still see where the furniture is. Then, bop the balloons around the room and share one thing that you love about Jesus each time you bop. Try not to let the balloons touch the ground. Pause the video here to play the game. As we come to the end of our lesson for today, I want you to think about these games and how they made you feel. What did you learn about Jesus today? And how can you share this experience with others? Pause the video here to talk with your family about these questions. Now, let's pray together. Dear God, we thank you for sending your Son Jesus to earth to be with us and teach us. Please help us to be willing to share our stories about how much we love Jesus and give us the chance to spread that love everywhere we go. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. See you next week!